Hey everybody, y'all, I'm Bay. I want to say I had a talk with one of my family members today, and I told you I was gonna bring this up in this video, so that's why I'm bringing it up. I had a talk with one of my family members, and I was asking them and talking. We talk about everything together, We talk about, we're just sitting around just cackling and talking about what happened back in the day. And we were talking about the Kim Burrell controversy with all the gays and situations and stuff, and all the fact that if she didn't come out to the LGBT. She said S-I-N. We was talking about all the stuff that she was saying about Yolanda Adams and stuff on the Tamara Hall show. So we got into that, and they were just telling me that they was okay, because I had said they was dropped some names, like she dropped some names on Tamara Hall show. They were dropping some names that it was like three people in the family that was gay. I said, well, I didn't know these people were gay because I never did go around them like that. You know what I'm saying? Because I consider myself a very private person when dealing with my lifestyle and dealing with my space. My space is my space, and I don't like anyone to interrupt my space. So when it was said to me that one of the family members was gay, and she said, I didn't even know he had passed away. But I didn't know two of the family members had passed away. So she was saying that one thing that she liked about him was when he stepped out, he was shy, he wasn't sagging. Okay, I understand that. I always, you know what I'm gonna say? I didn't know he was gay. I'm gonna say, I assume. But sometimes people tell you not to always assume, because assuming can get you in a whole lot of trouble. So, to make a long story short, I really just didn't come to the point to say, okay, well, he's this, he's that. So, to make a long story short, y'all, she was saying it. And she was saying that one thing she didn't respect, one thing that she respected about him and she liked about him, that he didn't let everybody know his business. He didn't let everybody know that he was gay, or he didn't let everybody know this or didn't know that. You know what I'm saying? She said, because the way I feel, everybody don't have to know that you're gay. You know, that's not for everybody to know, because I sure don't want to know. Okay, I understand that. And then she came back to say, well, if you want to tell somebody, well, that's on you, but all of this coming out the closet, you ain't gotta do all of that. But see, that's just what I'm saying. This is what I'm saying. Family members get upset, or people in general. I'm not going to just say family members. I'm going to just say people in general. Talk about you don't have to come out the closet because they don't want to hear that, you being gay. But I think they contradict themselves a lot. When I say I think you contradict yourself a lot, because when I say that if you don't want to hear certain things about the situation, it's an issue. You feel me? Because they'll sit there and say, the whole time you knew you was gay and you didn't let me know that you was gay and all that type of stuff. And I'd be like on some serious, saying to myself, they need help. mentally and physically, they need help. And I'd be like, I don't be understanding. So I was just like, when it was brought to my attention, I really didn't understand why people say things that then. I think is if they want to come out, it's their choice they want to come out. Whatever they want to do with themselves, I feel like it's their choice to do it. I feel like at the end of the day, we don't owe nobody no explanation on doing what we want to do because it's our life. And I feel like if you want to live in your truth to where you don't want to stay in the closet all your life and sneak behind closed doors, where you can love me and be in a relationship behind closed doors, but you don't want to be in a relationship in the open, in the open. I'm not doing that. I know I'm not. And so as she was saying these things, I kind of feel like that it was like, kind of like feel like it was sort of like grounded to me. I feel like that the pens or the pencils was being thrown at me. But I also feel like what I have to do be mad. If I decide I want to tell my story, I'm gonna tell my story because that's what you're doing. You're telling your story and you're telling your truth. Whether you telling your truth about you being HIV positive, or you telling your truth and your story about being gay, it's still your truth. And it's your truth and your story to tell. Just like they say, one of the things in mental health, the doctor said, you got to allow that patient to tell their truth and their story. Their truth and their story might be the whole different truth from what your truth and your story is. Yeah, I just sometimes feel like that in the world of society today, people don't understand what it's like living and breathing as a gay person or a transgender person. Or a sister person, whatever. I feel, although I'm gonna just say trans LGBT, period. That's just what I'm gonna say. I just feel like they don't understand what we go through in our everyday life. And I feel like just because you don't care to hear it, you don't have to hear it. If you see me post something on my page and you don't like it, do what most people do. Stroll up. That's what I do. When I see something posting, like some before I was doing YouTube, I seen something posting that I didn't like. I stroll up because I didn't like you. I didn't like it. I didn't want to hear it, and I didn't want to be a part of it. And that's just the way I feel about it. Yeah, that's just the way I feel about it. And I didn't care if nobody understood me, and I didn't care if nobody didn't understand me. So, yeah. But these people is delusional. One minute you say, come out the closet. And then the next minute you say, stay in the closet. Stop contradicting yourself. And just say what you want to say. That's why I say in this society, in the world today, I really ain't got no words. I really don't. Because when you think your own family members is by your side, they're really not. I said this before, and I say this time and time again. It ain't nothing but a high miss. That's all it is. As when they was talking about Kim Burrell, as a high miss, the whole situation about when your family say certain things to you that you don't like about your lifestyle is a high miss because I'm not living in my lifestyle for you. In other words, I'm not living in my truth for you. I'm living in my truth for me. So please keep your comments to yourself. And that's all I got to say.